Hey everybody, welcome back to My First Fish Tank and Marine Depot. We're gonna put 7 different nitrate test kits through the ringer today, and we're gonna let you know how much they cost, how durable they are, how easy they are to read. We're gonna show you how to use the test kits, look at the packaging, and then stick around to the end because we are gonna give you our best of test kit by category. Please consider subscribing to My First Fish Tank and Marine Depot, liking this video, and turning on those notifications. Links to all the test kits will be in the description below. And if you wanna see all the results written out in a blog format, just go to myfirstfishtank.com, click on the gear guides, and click on nitrate test kits. Okay, we're gonna do this alphabetically just like we did for the ammonia test kit, so that means first up is API. Overall, I'm just a big fan of API test kits, mainly because they're so affordable, and if you buy the Saltwater Aquarium Master Test Kit, it comes with some really durable packaging, much better than most of them out there, and for a really good price. At the time of filming this video, the API Nitrate Test Kit was retailing for $11.06 at Marine Depot, and with 90 nitrate tests in this little package, it comes out to, I believe, 12 cents per test, which, spoiler alert, it's gonna be the cheapest. Some test kits do come with reagents, but this one doesn't, so every time you need more reagent, you just have to buy the whole test kit. The API test kit is relatively fast. There's only a wait time of 5 minutes once you've mixed up all the reagents, and total time from start to finish takes me about 7 minutes, which puts it on the faster end of nitrate test kits. Ease of use, it's moderately easy to use. The biggest drawbacks I have found with the API test kits is the vials are super tall and super tippy, so they can tip over unless you're really careful. I've also noticed that sometimes the caps just, even though they feel that they're on tight, obviously aren't, because when you're doing the 1 minute long shake, you get some of that reagent spilling out. Not a ton, but enough to be annoying. For readability, I would call it moderately difficult to read because you read it through the curvature of the vial, so the light refraction can play tricks, and then how far away you hold it from the color chart also seems to darken or lighten the sample. And I also found at the lower ranges of this test kit, the 5 to 20 parts per million, the colors are a little bit hard to distinguish, so it's hard to pinpoint exactly where that nitrate level is. Quality and durability, if you're just buying the nitrate test kit, the packaging itself is just flimsy cardboard. If you do pick this up as a part of the Saltwater Master Test Kit, then it's extremely durable. But if you're just getting this, I will call it flimsy, but the articles inside, the glass vial and the reagent bottles, are actually pretty good. Hands down, the best characteristic of the API Nitrate Test Kit is the price. It's just so affordable, and you get 90 tests for under $12. That's just a great deal. And in my opinion, the worst part of the API nitrate test kit is the exact same thing that was worst with the API ammonia test kit. The vials are tippy, and some of the vials leak when you're shaking them. Next up in our alphabetical trek through the nitrate test kits is Aquaforest. Time of publication, this is retailing for $22 for 40 tests, which comes out to about 55 cents per test, significantly more expensive than the API test kit. And honestly, this is really hard to find online. I'm not even sure if it's available in the US right now. Once you use up all the test kits in here, there is no additional reagent you can buy, so you just have to rebuy the test kit each time. The Aquaforest Nitrate Test Kit is a little bit faster than the API. The wait time is only 3 minutes, and with mixing both the reagents in, It's about a 5-minute test overall. Ease of use, I would say it's easy to moderate, probably on the easier side. There's only 2 reagents, 1 powder, and then you have to draw 1 milliliter of a liquid reagent. Pretty easy to use. Readability, difficult. For some reason, I've done this test several times now. The shades of pink, especially at the higher ends, are really hard to tell apart. I like the tests that go from like a yellow to a red or change color, but this is all shades of pink. And in my experience using this test, the shades of pink don't really match. It's like a pink versus a purple, so that can kind of throw me off as well. I don't find this test kit easy to read, so I would say it's difficult. Quality and durability, flimsy-ish. It's just some inexpensive, cheap cardboard packaging. I thought at first that the color chart was just regular paper, but it is waterproof paper, which is relatively nice. The vial itself is nothing fancy, it's just a cheap plastic, so I would call this test kit flimsy-ish. So the best characteristic of the Aquaphor's nitrate test kit is the waterproof tester. I at first thought this was just regular paper, but it's not. It is waterproof paper, so you could completely submerge this and it wouldn't go bad. The worst characteristic of the Aquaphor's nitrate test kit, it's just not that readable in my opinion, especially at the higher end nitrate levels. I find it difficult to tell what exactly the difference is between those pinks when I'm reading it. Next up in our alphabetical march through the nitrate test kits, the Hanna Checker. At the time of filming this, the Hanna Nitrate Checker is retailing for $50, and at 25 tests, that means it's $2 per test. This is by far going to be the most expensive nitrate checker that we're looking at. But once you exhaust those initial 25 test kits, you can buy the reagent and filters, an additional 25 of them, for $20 total, and that will take the long-term testing price down to 80 cents per test. I've already done an entire video review of this test kit, so if you want to check that out, just click up here, it'll appear somewhere. It's the closest thing I've ever made to a negative review. I think it's a really great product. I just think it's probably gonna be too time consuming, too many steps, and too many places for possible error for the average hobbyist. The total wait time once you've completed all the steps is 8 minutes, but overall, this test takes me at the quickest 15 minutes up to around 18 minutes total. Ease of use, very difficult. Yes, I have seen some people say, well, it's not really that hard, but let's be honest, when you're comparing the number of steps, including dilution for anything over 5 parts per million, which is most of our tanks, there are so many steps, and not only that, there's one really challenging step, which is the filter. If you don't get that filter just right and screw that filter on, you'll have a leak and you'll have to start it all over again. Compared to all other 6 nitrate test kits, this test kit is the most difficult, so I would say it's very difficult. Readability, it's foolproof. That's the benefit of Hanna Checkers. You don't have to read the color, the machine does it for you. Quality and durability, it's durable. It comes in a solid plastic package. It's well made, the product itself is super durable, the glass vials are good. This is a high quality product. The best characteristic of the Hanna Nitrate Checker is its readability. It's foolproof. As long as you're willing to spend the time and you do the steps correctly, you're gonna get a super accurate reading. And the worst thing about the Hanna Nitrate Checker is the filtration process. If you don't have the little tiny clear O-ring or you misplace it, this whole thing doesn't work. While it's not that difficult overall, I've done it several times now, and 2 of the times I have messed up the filtration process, either because I installed the filter wrong, the O-ring was missing, or I didn't screw it on tight enough. Moving on to number 4 is one of my favorites, actually. The Nios Nitrate Checker is retailing for $25 for 40 tests, so it comes out to about 63 cents per test. And there are no reagents that you can purchase separately, so whenever you run out, you have to buy the whole test kit again. After you've mixed everything up with the Nios test kit, you have to wait about 5 minutes, and I found the entire process is about 7 minutes, right in the middle of the pack when it comes to nitrate test kits. Ease of use, this is an easy test kit. It comes with two really small vials. You can place those vials in little styrofoam packaging so they don't tip over. You only have two reagents, about 1 minute to shake them up, and then you wait for 5 minutes. So for ease of use, this is a really easy test kit to use. For readability, I would call the Nios Nitrate Checker easy to read, and really for a couple reasons. One, the colors themselves from yellow to orange, there's enough distance between them that it's relatively easy to pinpoint what your nitrate levels are. And number two, just like the Red Sea test kit, it comes with two vials. One vial is full of just your display tank water, and the other vial has the display tank water and the reagents. So when you're trying to match up the colors, you're actually looking straight down at both vials and moving them along the color board until they match. I just find that to be a more accurate way and an easier way for me to read the results. For quality and durability, I would call it moderately durable overall. If you're just looking at the packaging, it's really cheapy cardboard, so that part's flimsy, but the glass vials themselves do feel like a higher quality, so moderately durable. The best characteristic, in my opinion, is how easy it is to read, and that's largely due in part to the fact that it uses two vials to read the color. Not only that, but I also find the color differences between the yellow and the orange pretty easy to pick up. Certainly easier to pick up for me than the pinks and purples. The worst thing about the Nios Nitrate Test Kit, it's a little bit on the expensive side and the cardboard packaging is flimsy. Coming up next, number 5 of 7 for our nitrate test kits, Red Sea. There are currently two different ways to purchase the nitrate test kit from Red Sea. You can purchase it in a bundle like this one with phosphate, or you can purchase it in a standalone. If you do decide to purchase the nitrate test kit as a part of this bundle, you get 200 total tests between the two, and for $60, that comes out to 30 cents a test. Or you can just purchase the nitrate test kit by itself. It's retailing for about $43, so with 100 tests, it comes out to 43 cents a test. But one of the really nice things about the Red Sea nitrate test kit is, since the packaging is so durable and the contents are amazingly well made, you can buy reagents for this. You can pick up a reagent pack for $24 for 100. So every time you run out, it's only gonna cost you 24 cents per test from there on out. This is one of the lengthier tests. After you mix up the three reagents, you still have to wait 9 minutes, but the total process overall takes me about 15 minutes, almost as long as the HANA nitrate checker. For ease of use, I would say the Red Sea Nitrate Test Kit is moderately difficult. That's because there's quite a bit of setup involved. You have three different reagents, and then if you expect your nitrate levels to be above 4 parts per million, which pretty much everybody's is gonna be, you have to dilute it, which is an additional step. Readability, I think it's pretty easy to read. Some people struggle with the pinks and purples, and I get that. I struggle with that too. I find the oranges and the yellows to be a little bit easier, but this one's pretty easy to read because, just like the Nios Nitrate Test Kit, it uses two vials, one vial with just display tank water and the other vial with the reagents, and then you have to look straight down and spin a color wheel until both of them match. So as long as you're in relatively good lighting, I do find this easy to read. Quality and durability, it's durable. I mean, it comes in a solid cardboard packaging, but not only that, inside the cardboard packaging comes a durable plastic container. The vials are glass. Everything just feels heavy and well made. So this is definitely a durable product. In my opinion, the best characteristic of the Red Sea Nitrate Test Kit is the method of reading it. I really like their color wheel system. So you just put the two vials down, look straight down, and you turn the color wheel until both colors are matching. It's just really easy to read and use, even though it takes quite a bit of setup to get to that point. The worst characteristic of this test kit is that you have to dilute anything above 4 parts per million. For pretty much all of us, you're going to always have to dilute it. But on the other hand, one of the good things that means is you probably have a more accurate reading at the lower ranges of nitrate. So it's a trade-off. Only 2 more nitrate test kits to go, and second to last is Salifert. Did watch my ammonia test kit video, you'll see I didn't really care much for the Salifert ammonia test kit, but this one is quite a bit better. Even though the quality is about the same, I just found it much easier to use overall. The Salifert nitrate test kit cost me $17.37. And since it comes with 60 tests, the total is 29 cents per test. It's definitely on the more affordable end, but still a lot more than API. Again, like most of the other nitrate test kits, once you run out, there is no reagent to buy, so you do have to repurchase the entire test kit. The wait time for the Salifert test kit is 3 minutes, but from start to finish, it took me about 5 minutes, so it's definitely one of the faster nitrate test kits out there. Ease of use, this is probably the easiest nitrate test kit I've ever used. You can add both reagents at the same time. You don't even have to put the cap on, and then you just swirl it for 30 seconds and you're done. Readability, it's easy to read. For normal nitrate levels, you just look straight down and compare the colors, and not only is it really easy to read from the top down, but if the nitrate levels are low, you can actually hold the vial up and look through it to get a more accurate reading at the lower end of the nitrate range. This is the only test kit that gives an option like that. Quality and durability, it's flimsy. It's probably the flimsiest one out there. The plastic vial is so cheap, I could just break it between my fingertips, and the cardboard packaging is just that, really thin cardboard packaging. My 2 favorite characteristics of the Salifert nitrate test kit is that it's both a high range and a low range test kit in one test, which is really cool, and it's just super fast. It takes under 5 minutes. This is probably the fastest nitrate test kit out there. And of course, the worst characteristic of the Salifert nitrate test kit, it's pretty flimsy. And last but not least, the 7th nitrate test kit we're looking at today comes from Seachem. If you remember from the ammonia test kit video, the Seachem ammonia test kit, number one, I did it wrong, and number two, it is just not my favorite test kit. It's actually one of my least favorite test kits, but the Seachem nitrite and nitrate test kit is definitely better than their ammonia test kit, in my opinion. At the time of this video, the Seachem nitrite and nitrate test kit cost $14.80 for 75 tests, so that comes out to 20 cents a test. You can't buy reagents, so whenever you run out, you just have to buy the whole test kit again. Once you've added the reagents, your wait time's 5 to 8 minutes, and I would say the total time from start to finish is about 8 minutes overall. For ease of use, I would say this is easy to use. It's different than all the other nitrate checkers because you're not putting anything in a vial. You're just filling up these little cavities. You only have to add 1 drop of solution and 1 scoop of a powder, and then gently mix it up and wait. Probably one of the easier test kits to use. Readability, it's moderately difficult, moderate to moderately difficult to read. It just has a really kind of flimsy color chart, and you have to just hold it up near where the reagent is, and it's a little hard to get an accurate reading, at least in my opinion. Again, it's that pink and purple, not the yellow and orange, which I just find a little bit more difficult to get an accurate reading of. Quality and durability, it's a flimsy test kit. Both the packaging is just a thin cardboard, and the contents inside are kind of a cheapy plastic. Hands down, the best characteristic of the Seachem nitrite and nitrate test kit is it's both test kits in one. You can actually perform a nitrite test kit and then just continue on with that same sample and do a nitrate test kit. No other test kit does that I know of. And the worst characteristic of the Seachem nitrite test kit, it's just kind of clunky to use and it's really quite flimsy. So which is my favorite nitrate test kit? Let me break it down by category. First category is the least expensive test kit. I'm sure you guys already know the answer. No doubt, API. Coming in at 12 cents a test, it is by far the least expensive. If you were to go with the most expensive, the Hanna Checker, that is over $2 a test for your initial 25 tests. It does get cheaper after that, but if you need to save some money, absolutely, API is your least expensive nitrate test kit out there. Highest quality test kit, I couldn't decide, so I narrowed it down to two. Highest quality, number one, Red Sea. My second choice for highest quality was the Hanna Checker. Both of them come with just really good packaging overall, a heavy duty plastic case, and then the vials and the items themselves inside just feel super durable. So my winner for highest quality is a tie between Hanna and Red Sea. Okay, so easiest to read, there's only one winner. I mean, without a doubt, it's Hanna. Hanna's the easiest to read because you don't have to read it. It does the reading for you. So what was the winner amongst the other six test kits? For me, it was the NIOS. The yellows and oranges are easy to distinguish, and the fact that they use two vials to read the results, I don't know, I just found this test kit really easy to read. Easiest to use, this one was easy for me as well, Salifert. You don't even have to put the top on, there's no shaking of reagents. You can add both reagents at the same time, and then it's a super short 30-second twirl. I mean, you really can't get much easier to use than the Salifert Nitrate Test Kit. All right, the moment you've been waiting for, if you've watched this long, my overall choice, my best pick for saltwater aquarium nitrate test kits, and I couldn't narrow it down to one. It really goes to two. I don't think you're gonna go wrong with either the Salifert or the NIOS. They're both very different test kits, but they're a good middle of the road between price point, ease of use, and readability. So pick up one of these, you won't be disappointed. If you found this video helpful at all, please do consider subscribing to My First Fish Tank and Marine Depot, turning on notifications, and liking this video. That really helps our channels. Links to all seven test kits you saw are in the description below. If you would prefer to see the written blog version of this video, go to myfirstfishtank.com, click on Gear Guides, and go down to Nitrate Test Kits. Coming up in our next Best of Saltwater Aquarium Test Kits, we'll do either calcium or phosphate. Probably calcium. Happy reefing, everybody. We'll see you next time.